So good morning, students. Yeah. Okay. So in the last class, you studied about your what is organizing here. So what is the meaning, definition, and also the what is the steps of organizing process here. And also you studied about what are the advantages and also disadvantages here, and also features of that, and also importance of organizing. I think so maybe. Next, we will go for the next one, that is about your organization structure. There also you have studied about your functional structure and also division structure here. And next, upcoming this one, yeah. So we are going for the next step or next topic of this chapter, that is about your formal organization and also informal organization here. Okay, so what is this formal organization here? Formal organization here, so it is clearly cut meaning of this here. So formal organization refers to the organization structure which is designed by the management to accomplish a particular task. It specifies clearly about the authorities and also responsibility. What is this, sir? Okay, so I think so we go back to our levels of management here. Just I will make a small chart like this here. So I think so you studied here. So we have a top level, okay, we have a middle level here, and also low level here. That is about the supervisor level, we call it as a low level. Low level management is there here. Okay, here there is a clear cut message, and there will be clear cut rules and regulations, authorities, responsibility here. Whatever the things is happened or what are the things is given, the directions are given by the top level management, it has to be followed by the middle level. And what the middle people or middle level people, they said here, the low level or the supervisor level has to follow this here. This is nothing but here, this is called the formal organization here. Okay, it's clear cut message here to whom you are responsible, what has to be done, what has to be done by you people here. Okay, this is called the formal organization. Yeah, once again I repeat here, formal organization refers to the organization structure which is designed by the management to accomplish a particular task. What task here? It's a, whether it is an organizational goal or whatever may be, whether it is a profit of the organization here, where whatever the things here. So particular task to be succeeded here, and it has been specified or clearly about the authorities and responsibility framed by the top level management here, whether it's a CEO, whether MD or general body members here, whatever may be. Okay, this is called the formal organization here, which is clearly a set of rules and regulations framed by the top level management here. Okay, here next step we go for the next one, that is our definition here. Okay, one person called as Lewis Allen. Okay, he has given one definition regarding that here. So according to this Lewis Allen here, the formal organization is a system. Okay, we have a well-defined job, each bearing a definite measure of authorities, responsibility, and also accountability. Okay, it is nothing but a meaning of the formal organization here. So Lewis Allen, this says, okay, about that formal organization here, it is nothing but a formal organization is a system of a well-defined job, each bearing a definite measure of authority, responsibility, and also accountability. So he will define here. So might be you will get here. So 2 marks they may ask here. Define formal organization means here. You should be answer for this one. Yeah, okay. Next one here. Sir, what is the feature? How can we know whether it is a formal organization or informal organization here? How to identify, how to see that whether it is a formal organization or informal organization here? Okay. Next one, that is about the features. How can we know this means here? So I have a 5 features of a formal organization here. The first and foremost here, it specify the relationship among various job positions here. This is the first and foremost here. So okay, the first and foremost, it specify the relationship among the various job positions here. Okay, sir, I am an employee. So whatever the work I done here, to whom I am responsible here, to whom I want to report here. So to whom what I done here, to whom I want to give the clear cut message or something here. Okay, so all the things here in the formalization, okay, all the things are clear cut message will be there. Okay, Mr. A is there here. Mr. A has to report to B. Okay, clear cut message. Okay, the employee has to report to the Mr. B. Okay, this is a formal organization. Okay, so it specifies the relationship among various job positions here. Okay, that's clear cut. Next one, it means to achieve the objectives specified as per the plans here. Okay, I think so. I told you in the first class here, that is about organizing chapter here, in the first beginning itself. It is the second function of a management here. First one is the planning. Okay, what plan you are done, so what to do, when to do, how to do, what business has to do, yeah, all the things are ready. There's the plans are ready now here. Next step, it is about organizing. That's the second step, that second function of a management means here. So what plan you are done, what plan you are done here, this formal organization will achieve the objectives specified as per the plans here. Okay, what plan you have made here, this formal organization will helps to, okay, helps to go for that goal or to achieve that goal here. So that is that it means to achieve the objectives specified in the plan. So what plan you have made here, it will helpful for your achieving your group goals or your organizational goals here. Next one, efforts of various departments are coordinated and interlinked here. Okay, I think so. I discussed in the last class also, there will be so many departments will be there here. Okay, in the functional structure. Okay, for example, we have a purchase department, marketing department, finance department. Okay, there's a godown department like this. Something will be there here. Sales department like this, it will be there here. Okay, here in the formal organization here, to whom you should be reported, to whom you are liable to pay, liable to inform or something here. Okay, here in the formal organization here, it efforts the various departments are coordinated and interlinked here. To other departments or the so many departments are interlinked in the formal organization here. Okay, so you are interconnected to the each department. That's the third one. Fourth one, it is designed by the top management. Very much important. Yeah, I told you regarding here. Okay, in the levels of management also here. Okay, it is been designed by the top management. Yeah, top management here, what they say regarding this. Okay, you should be follow this here. What are the rules and regulations? Okay, what the framework, what be done by the top management here. Okay, you have to follow that here. It is nothing but here, it is a formal organization here. Understood? Okay, next one, we'll go for the next one. That's the fifth one here. Yeah? That's the next feature here. Yeah? It gives more importance to the work than the interrelationship among the employees here. Yeah? Okay, so they'll give you more importance to the work here. Okay, so there's clear-cut message here. What work have to done here? By what time? To whom to be reported? Everything is clear-cut here. Okay, as per the plan, it will goes here. But, okay, there is no discrimination here. He is boss or he is more than me. Okay, nothing here. Okay, you should not, overly smart or something. No. Okay, whatever the things is there here, you gives more importance to the work here. Not for the employees here. Okay, he is the senior most here. Okay, he is from the political background. No, nothing here. Okay, you have a work here. Your work has been assigned to you. You should follow. That's all. Okay, that is nothing but yeah, it is about the formal organization. Okay, so it is about the meaning, definition, and also features of this here. Understood? Okay, so next one. So we will move to the next one, that is about the advantages of formal organization here. So by taking or adopting the formal organization system here, so what are the advantages that you, okay, you feel or it will be helpful for you people means here. So I have a 5 advantages here. So what are the advantages means here? It is a fixed responsibility here. Okay, so again I'm saying that here, so it's a fixed responsibility here. So to whom you have to report here, so what work you have to do, okay, to whom to be reported here, everything it's fixed here. Okay, it is fixed by the top level management here. So you need not to ask anybody. You need not to ask anybody here. So you go ahead with the what work they assigned here. You go ahead. So it is a fixed responsibility here. So it will be, okay, wastage of time. Okay, it will be create this one here. It will not be wastage of time here. So it will be effective utilization of your resources here. Everything will be there here. So that's why it's a fixed responsibility here. That's the first one here. Next one, second one here. Formal organization helps to avoid the duplication of work here. I told you regarding here, to whom you to be reported here. Okay, so the duplication of work here, so nothing here. For whom you are assigned the work here, they have to do. Okay, that is clear cut here. That's the second one here. Third one here, so unity of command is maintained. That is the scalar chain here. Okay, so scalar chain here, I think so you have studied in the second chapter. That is about principles of management here. So scalar chain is nothing but here, it's a It's nothing but it is a clear cut message in the formal organization. Yeah. So to whom to be reported? Yeah. From top level to middle level, middle level to low level. Yeah. So it's a unity of command is maintained. That is a scalar chain. Yeah. Okay. Unity of command is maintained. Yeah. Next one. So that is a fourth one. Yeah. It leads to effective accomplishment of your goals. Yeah. Okay. What goal? Yeah. So whether it's a profit of the organization. Yeah. Whether it's a input output of our organization. Yeah. Whatever may be. Yeah. Okay. It leads to effective accomplishment of your goals of an organization. Yeah. Next one, it's about fifth one. It provides the stability to the organization because employees' behavior can be predicted. Yeah. Okay. So how the employees are working here? Okay. What is their action, reaction? Okay. What is this behavior? All the time you can be predicted or you can be see what the employees are doing here. What the employees output? Everything it can be predicted. Yeah. So it provides stability of an organization here because employees' behavior can be predicted in the formal organization. These are most advantages that we can see in the formal organization. And also in another hand, okay, for there is a thing is there, yeah. So whether right is there, wrong also should be there, yeah. Okay, there's the advantages there means disadvantages also should be there. Okay, like this, yeah. In this formal organization, yeah, we have some disadvantages also here. So what are the disadvantages here? So it may delay in the decision making. The first and foremost, it is about disadvantages here. Yeah? It may delay in the decision making. Yeah, I think so. I told you regarding this, top level management is there, middle level management is there, and also low level management is there here. Yeah? Okay, so whatever the things to be done means, yeah, whether anything has to be done by the employees here, yeah, you should be asked your seniors or the superiors or the head of the department here. Yeah? Okay, so that's way. So it will be leads to delay in your decision making. Yeah, any fast thing has to be done. Yeah, no, you can't do it. Why? Because there is a hierarchy is there. Yeah, the top level management has to be reported to the has to send a report to the middle level management. Middle level management has to send a report to the low level management. Then only these people can do the work here. Until unless the decision is taken by the top level management, you can't do anything here. There's a first disadvantage that can be seen in the formal organization here. You can't take your own decisions here. The employees can't take your own decisions here until unless the top management, they give the clear cut instructions to you. Okay, that's the first one here. It may delay in the decision making. Second one here, poor organization practice may not provide the adequate recognition to creative talented here. Okay, if you feel, okay, I am an employee of this one, yeah. So more than the employee here, so I am a talented person. For example, I'm saying here, okay, your employee is more talented here, okay. But in the formal organization, as per the rules or as per the plans, okay, what they're given by the top level manager, that much only you have to do here. More than that, no, there is no clear cut message or there will no such things will be happen here. Okay, what we say, just do it here. So that will leads to, okay, so that will bring so adequate recognition of your creative talents here. Okay, now the new generation is coming here. Okay, more talented employees are coming to here. Okay, so you are using the old type of organization method or something here, but now the generation has been improved, or the next generation is coming here, they have a more talented than you people here. Okay, so here in the formal organization, no. Okay, there is no such things here to show your talent in the formal organization here. There's a second one. That's a disadvantage to the company, and also that is a disadvantage to the employees also here. Okay, third one. It is difficult to understand all the human relationship. Okay, so it does not provide the complete picture of how an organization is work here. Okay, once again, yeah, it is difficult to understand all the human relationship here. Okay, they may. Okay, why? Because we are the human beings here. We have also ego. Okay, we have our selfishness. Okay, sadist. Everything will be there here. Okay, we are the human beings here. So here in the formal army, we cannot understand the human relationship here. Okay, human relationship you can't understand here. Yeah, whether so they, you are smiling in face of your boss here, but inside he may scold you. All the things will be there, yeah. So it could be, and you can't understand the human relationship, yeah. So it does not provide a complete picture how the organization is working, yeah. So this will be, okay. So how it has to be work, yeah. Everything will be difficult to understand or to recognize what the work is going on, yeah. This is a disadvantage, okay. So advantages and also disadvantages will be there in the formal organizations, yeah. Okay. Next, we will move for the next one. That is about your informal organization, yeah. Okay, now you are, till now you have studied what is formal organization here. Okay, what are the features, advantages and disadvantages here. Next, we'll go for the next one, that is the informal organization here. What is this informal organization here? Okay, so we have a meaning here. Informal organization is nothing but here. Interaction among the people at work give rise to the network of social relationship among employees. Okay, here there is no procedure, no rules, but it creates on the personal attitude, likes and dislikes, emotions, etc. Yeah. So what is this, sir? Okay, again I come for the levels of management, yeah. That is about, yeah, this is a top, middle level and also low level, yeah. Correct, yeah? So here, sir, anything to be, okay, any rules and regulations has to be framed by the top level management, yeah. It has to be followed by the middle level, it has to be followed by the low level, yeah. That is a clear cut message, that is a formal organization, yeah. Okay, I give one a best example for you people here. Okay, so you are at work, okay, you are working in a place here, so urgent from the this one in your house here, you have got a call, okay, some your parent has been hospitalized here or something has happened in the at home here. Okay, what do you do here? As per the rules here, you have to inform your seniors, you have to inform your superiors here. It has to go for the top level management, then the if leave has been sanctioned here, okay, then you have to take the leave here and you have to go to the home here. That is actually a formal line of communication here. Now there is no time at all here to go and report and all here. So what you have to do means here, so here the this one, so behaving the emotions here, there is no procedures, there is no what is that, the attitude, okay, based on the personal things here. They're based on the personal attitudes here. So you will make off this here. Okay, you will make off this informal. So you say for your friend or your colleagues, okay, please tell to the superior, what is that, so seniors or the superior body to that, yeah. So I have an urgent call here, or an urgent has to go here. This is all we call as an informal organization here. And moreover here, okay, whatever the work that you do, okay, there is no rules, there is no procedures, nothing here. Based on your personal attitude, likes and dislikes here, and also your emotion here, the work will be done here. Okay, your emotions here, okay, whatever things here, the boss will say, hey, whatever done you do here, but I want this much. By the evening, I need this much of output here. Okay, there's no rules and he will tell, he will go, that's all. But here, so based on the things, what do you have emotions and also likes and dislikes, yeah, the company will move or your organization will go for that, yeah. Okay, there is no clear cut message to whom to be reported, nothing will be there here. Okay, so this is about your meaning here. So interaction among the people at work, okay, at work itself, yeah, give rise to the network of social relationship among the employees here, okay, within the employees here, the employees itself, they will join together. This is my company, we will do like this, okay. If they feel of oneness, this is my company, like means if they feel, yeah, okay, so you can work for that, yeah. There is no procedure will be there here, there is no rules, but it is created on the personal attitude here. Okay, personal attitude and also emotions here. Next, we'll go for the what are the features of this, of informal organization means here. So it is a personal interaction between the employees here. Sir, like this we'll do. Okay, if at all we done means here, it will be output like this here. It will be more colorful, it will be more effective, it will be more attractive to the customers here. Like this, it will be a personal interaction between the employees here. Okay, might be there is just like a group discussion in your companies here. Okay, they will sit together, they will, okay, sir, we will do like this here. Okay, interaction will be there, yeah. So it will be features here. Yeah? So whatever the work you do, okay, with the interaction within the employees here, yeah, the work will be progress here. Okay, the top level management, they will not interfere in your interaction or in your decision making here. Okay, so whatever work you do it here. That is left to you. That's the first one. It's a personal interaction between the employees here. Second one, there is no official rules and regulations here. No. Okay, there is no rules and regulations here. So, morning 9 o'clock, you should come here. Till 5 o'clock, you have to work here. That's the official. That's the formal organization rules and regulations here. But here, no. No such like things here. There is no official rules and regulations here. But they say, so much of output has to come by this time. That's all. There is no rules and regulations. Whether you do by 1 o'clock, whether you do by 2 o'clock, whether you do by 1 hour or 2 hours, left to you. Okay. There is no rules and regulations about that, what work you have to do here. Okay. Third one. So, independent channel of communication without specified directions of flow of information developed by the group members. I think so. So, any information has to flow from a top level to middle level to low level here. That is our formal things here. But here, no such things will be there here. Directions of flow of information developed by the group members itself here. Okay. There is a small group of members will be there by consist of 5 members or 7 members. Okay. Depend upon the company. This one here. Size of the company here. Okay. They will develop a group members here. So they will interact or they will be understanding between the employees itself or the group members itself. Yeah. They will work together. Okay. To work what work has to be done here. Okay. That's a group what the group goals has to be achieved here. Everything here. So here independent channel will be given to each group here. Okay, each group will be there, yeah. So, directions of flow of information developed by the group members. Okay, you please report to this person, yeah. That's all, over. But it is not framed by the top level, yeah. It is not framed by the top level, yeah. Just they will develop their group members, okay. So, after you work here, please inform to that person. Okay, that's that developed by group members here. Next year, fourth one. It is not purposefully created by the management here. Again, I am saying that here. Okay, these informal organization are not purposefully created by the management here. Depend upon the size of the company here, depend upon the what work here, what the plan here. So depend upon that here. So this informal organization has been created here. Okay, so it is not purposefully. Okay, so why like this only you have to do? No. Okay, it is not purposeful. Depend upon the size, depend upon the environment of the company here, or depend upon the what political things here, what are the business environment what we see here. Based on that, we will make this organization, whether it is a formal organization or informal organization here. Okay, and the last one, it has no definite organization structure. It has no definite organization here. There is no flow. There is no scalar chain. There is no hierarchy. Nothing is there here. There is no definite organization structure is there here. To whom to be reported here. Whether today you reported to Mr. A, tomorrow you should be reported to Mr. B. Okay, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, Mr. C. Okay, so there is no clear cut definite organization structure will be there in this informal organization here. Okay, so we'll go for the next one. That's the next topic of this informal organization. That's the advantages of informal organization and also disadvantages of informal organization here. Okay, first we see what are the advantages of informal organization here. Okay, the first and foremost here, so it will be prescribed line of communication are not followed here. Okay, so not followed here, prescribed line of communication are not followed, so leads to fast spreading of information here. Okay, information here. This one, yeah. So it will be prescribed line of communication are not followed. So it leads to fast spreading of information here. For example, I told you regarding levels of management, yeah. Anything to be followed or any line of communication to be followed, it has to be from the top level management here. That's the formal communication here. But here, such things is not there in the informal communication here. So it will be okay to ask or to make a decision making fastly or quickly like this, yeah. Here in the informal organization, there is no need to that, yeah. Whatever the things or whatever the decisions to be taken, you can take fastly and you not be asked to anybody, yeah. So it will be leads to a fast spreading of information here. Okay, so go ahead with the things here, what has to be happened in the future like this, yeah. So we have a prescribed line of communication will be there here, not followed here, and it has to be followed by the employees itself here. Next one, it helps to fulfill the social needs of the members here. Okay, what are the social needs here? I think so you have studied in the, it is not coming to you still here. So next upcoming chapters will be there here, social needs of here. So first one, okay, what we need here? We need a house. Okay, we need shelter. That is our third, yeah. Shelter, we need water, food like this, yeah. Next one, social needs here. Yeah. Okay, we want some job securities, love, affection, like this it will come here. So it helps to fulfill your social needs here. So I want to grow up, okay, I want to live, or my standard of living should be increased here. So everything will be succeeded in this informal organization here. It helps to fulfill the social needs of the members here. Okay, everything here. What work you have done here, such or that much of appreciation will be get you, and also just excretia will also give you, okay. So your per capita income also will increase here in this type of organization here. Next one, third one, it contributes towards the fulfillment of organization objectives, example their plans and also policies here, okay. It will contribute towards here, okay. What does say, whatever things you do here, that is left to you, but within the boundaries of a company's rules and regulations you should be aware here. It contributes towards the fulfillment of organization objective. So what work have to done here, everything will be done here within the organization limits here. Okay, this is the advantages to you people here. Next one, there's another hand is there here, that is called disadvantages here. So what are the disadvantages here? Means here, when a formal organizer spread rumors, it becomes the destructive force here. Okay, rumors about their employees, okay, its work or anything here, okay. So it will be directly or indirectly, it will affect the organization structure itself here. There's a major disadvantage in every company here, okay. So rumors should be not be followed to you people here, okay. That's when an informal organization spread rumors here, it becomes the destructive force here. Okay, so destructive force will be there. Next one, second one, the management may not be successful. That is the second one here. The management may not be successful in implementing the changes if the informal organization opposite here. Okay, the management may not be successful here. Okay, they may give some plans. Okay, but here in the informal organization, the management itself, they give some plans, means here, yeah? If these people, these informal people here, that's the members of the groups here, they oppose it, means, okay, the plans will not be succeeded here. If the management may not be successful in implementing the changes if the informal organization opposes it here. Okay, what these people, what they say here, that is the final year in the informal organization. There is no work or there is no things will happen by the top level management in such this organizations here. Okay, you should be very careful regarding this. This one, this is the most important disadvantages in the informal organization. Okay. So we come to the last point, that is about the third point of your disadvantages of informal organization here. It gives pressure to the members to join group and group expectations here. Okay, suppose some of the people, they will be there here, okay, to not to join that group or this group like this here. So even though like this, if you feel not to go here, so I will take the permission from the top level management here like this. If you suppose you're feeling, means here, no, in such this organization here, they will not allow to do the work, okay. So as much independent here, so it gives more pressure to the members to join the group here. Okay, you join to our group, this group like this here. So there will be pressure will be there here to join group, and also group expectations also will be more here. Okay, you should do like this, you should not do like this here. Everything will be there here. So that's all these three disadvantages will be there in the informal organization. Okay, so we'll meet in the next class here. Okay, have a nice day. Thank you very much here.